Good morning, good evening, folks. Welcome to another daily market update. This is Eric Hale. Today is the 22nd of September, 2022. So the purpose of our meeting today is to do a quick review of the markets, take a look at maybe some stocks and events this week. I think all of the news that we're experiencing right now today is sort of the echoes of what happened yesterday. So yesterday was the FOMC meeting where the Fed announced that it was going to stick with another 75 basis point hike. I think that was pretty well broadcast. If we look at today's, today was pretty much a flat day. So we were actually down about 31, 32 points roughly on the S&P 500. We opened the day a little bit higher, and this is, looks like a pretty volatile day, but it's not. If we take a step back, this is a one-day intraday. If we take a step back and look at a five-day, here's our day today. So this really, while we did have some gyrations in the market, this was the volatile day. So the Jerome Powell announcement that began at 2 o'clock. So the Fed release came out, the Powell press conference came out at 2:30. There was hope, there was fear, there was everything. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. The only thing the VIX tells you is the relative expensiveness of put options that expire in 30 days. That's the only thing the VIX really does. And you can make certain sort of conclusions from that, but it's a really wonky, weird thing. It is an ugly, ugly instrument to look at. So that explains why. And I know this probably for some of you is like, well, yeah, that's, don't put a lot of faith in the VIX. It's an ugly, ugly instrument. So this is the Fed is everything right now. That's what's moved the markets. There are some disturbing things that are happening in Europe right now. Ukraine, of course, and that potentially escalating, but the energy crisis, what we're seeing is energy companies failing in Europe and having to be nationalized. That could have some interesting ramifications here in a sort of obscene way. What's happening in Europe can actually help the United States because some of the manufacturing that would be done there would move here. And that's not, I don't want to win. I don't think you win by pushing other people down or at the harm of other people or countries. That's not how I want to be winning. So it's an unfortunate situation. We're keeping an eye on it. I'm surprised right now that we're not seeing more impact to our markets. So I think it's, I wonder how much of it is already priced in. But knowing that there's going to be these points when the stock is going to be more volatile, that I think is something you can take into consideration. Not which way is the market going to go, but is the market going to go? And we as option traders have the ability to take advantage of that sort of thing. And we can either place trades that benefit from a change in volatility in either direction. We can close trades, we can protect trades. So there's lots of different things that you can do knowing that these points of volatility are coming up. All right. So thanks for your time. Look forward to seeing you in another class real soon. Everybody take care.